Hello everyone, this is Farhanur. Today we'll learn about cells. What is cells? Cells is the fundamental unit of life. Today we will be looking at the first characteristics in detail, which is a composition of an organism. But I want to image the trees in the forest, the fish in the river, the birds in the sky, the worm in the soil, the tiger in the jungle, the cactus in the desert, and all your classmates sitting next to you. All these things are mentioned, or in fact any living things in this planet is made up of cells, which are also known as building block of living things, and many cells come together to form a living organism. But besides this, some organisms like bacteria are made up of only one cells. One cell organism is altogether an individual itself, which can perform all the functions like any other multicellular organism. So as we all know, every organism performs various functions during its entire life span, like say respiration, nutrition, excretion, regulation, transportation, reproduction, etc. And the body has specific organs to carry out these functions. These organs are made up of various types of tissues, and tissues are nothing but a group of cells. So we can say that the human body is composed of many cells. Just as bricks form the important part of the building, cells make up an organism. So we can say that cells are the basic fundamental unit of life. So how were the cells discovered? So let's come to that. In 1665, Robert Hooke discovered cells. He observed dead cells within the cork of the bark of a tree using an old basic microscope. He observed empty spaces contained by a wall and named them cells because they resemble small compartments. So we can say that Robert Hooke actually observed look something similar to a honeycomb structure. So now we will take a look at some features of a cell. So let's get started. Number of cells. Based on the number of cells, an organism can either be unicellular or multicellular. As the word suggests, uni means one cells, like amoeba, bacteria, paramecium. They all have a single cell. And on the other hand, multi means many cells, like plants, animals, they all consist of many cells. Second one is shape of a cell. Cells are of various shapes. Majority of them are round, spherical, and elongated. But do you know what exactly gives a cell its shapes? Just like a room gets its shapes from its walls, a cell gets its shape from a cell membrane, which is the outer covering of the cell. So talking about shape of cells, you know a unicellular organism named amoeba has no definite shape. It is irregular and keeps changing its shape. And on the other hand, in multicellular organisms, cells are of different shapes. Like muscle cells is a spindle shape, a nerve cell is long and branches in its structure, while a RBC is spherical and concave. So coming to the size of cells. So cells are very tiny in size and are not visible to the eyes. Hence to view them we use a microscope, which is an instrument that magnifies and enlarges the image of the cell. So did you all know that a smallest cell is 0.1 to 0.5 micrometer, which is of a bacteria, while the largest cell is 170 millimeter to 130 millimeter in size, which is the largest egg of an ostrich. But you all know that the size of a cell is based on the functions it performs and not on the size of an organism. So when I say nerve cells will be a same size in an elephant and in rat. So till now we have been saying that biology is all about study of life, but life is composed of many cells. which come together to form a living organism. Our planet consists of a vast number of creatures. Some may be formed of just one cell, like we have seen in an amoeba, while others are multicellular. Number of cells can vary depending on the size of an organism, just like the elephant and rat example. Elephant will obviously have more number of cells compared to a rat, but the size of a cell will remain the same as we have seen previously. Also, cells have a property of regeneration. So imagine you have got a wound on your knee and your skin cells are damaged, but your body has a tendency to regenerate those cells on its own. And this is the process of healing because of the body immunity, and this regeneration property is the most fascinating property of cells. So when we study of cells, we need to know that what is the cells composed of. So to tell you, the cells has many components which help in proper functioning of cells, and we'll be looking in next video. So why didn't you do small exercise during this entire video? I have tried naming of few cells found in the human system, like for example RBC. So can you try it listed down type of cells found in the human system? Keep thinking about it. Until that next video, try following your curiosity. So that's all about introduction of cells. I hope you understand all about cells. If you like this video, hit the like button, share it with your friends, and please subscribe our channel to get more videos like that. Thank you. Bye-bye.